Hitler opens his eyes and wakes up in modern-day Germany. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe. Smash that like button, and ding that notification bell. This story begins at some point during World War II and is set in Berlin. Der Führer, Hitler, is seen with a behavior coach by the name of Keppel. There is an issue with the greeting that people give to Keppel. Hitler makes it clear that the salute is old-fashioned and needs to be altered. He then narrates how he has destroyed the enemies that dared to desecrate German soil. In the following scene, Adolf wakes to find himself on the ground, somewhere in an unknown forest. Glancing up at the sky, he can see no enemy aircraft overhead. Perhaps they're missing, he thinks to himself. As that thought comes, a red rubber ball bounces to a stop next to his right boot. Raising himself just enough, he can see a building past the bush that is obscuring his vision, as well as three young children that ask if he is okay. These children are the future of the nation, Hitler thinks to himself. As he asks them the way to the nearest street, a reporter, Fabian Sawatsky, is filming the children and captures Hitler as well. Donning his cap as he rises to his feet, Adolf tells himself that he must get to the Führer bunker. Walking to the nearby street, he is amazed to see several people riding mono-wheel bicycles. A few people manage to capture the image of Adolf Hitler walking about, glancing at them as though they have gone mad. Running his hand over a nearby, modern-style automobile, Hitler silently questions if he has fallen into a coma, and missed the victory he'd sought. The surreal nature of his surroundings seeks to disorient Adolf, but he presses forward as he asks a nearby man where Chancellery is. Unfortunately, the man is more interested in taking a picture with Der Führer. The sudden flash of several bulbs is disturbing in the next moment as Hitler is bombarded by several individuals who want their picture with him. Confused and off balance at that moment, Hitler quickly deduces that something is off about this moment, but the confusion of the moment causes Hitler to walk away, still disoriented as he passes by a window where he sees a woman speaking to someone on the phone. Upon stepping closer to ask her about the date, the woman screams at the sudden intrusion and sprays a fine mist into Hitler's eyes. Blinded and in pain, Adolf cries out as he stumbles into a nearby newspaper stand. Shock races through his mind as he sees the date, October 13, 2014. Blinded, confused, and unable to process the moment, Hitler slumps to the ground, momentarily defeated. Elsewhere, Kerner, the boss of a local TV station, praises the deputy's head, Christoph Sensbrink, for his fine work. Kerner proposes a better solution to the matter being discussed at that moment, and in the next breath introduces Katja Bellini, the managing director who will be helping out. Unfortunately, this new announcement shocks Christoph, causing him to storm off to his own office where he quickly selects a new and upcoming filmmaker, Fabian, who is forced to withstand Christoph's tirade. Despite his best attempts to defend his work, Fabian is unable to quell his boss's temper and is fired shortly after. Adding to this indignation, Fabian is escorted from the building by security, as per Christoph's orders. Recovering after a short amount of time, Hitler asks the newsstand owner if the date on his publications are accurate. When the individual affirms that yes, it is 2014, Hitler accuses the owner of kidnapping him and staging some elaborate trick to fool him. After threatening to have the owner killed if he's working for the enemy, Hitler is surprised as the individual calmly hands him a chocolate bar. After a moderate struggle to open the candy, Adolf notes that it is industrially pressed, and asks the owner if there is still a bread shortage. The individual answers by asking Hitler if there is a documentary being filmed nearby since he looks like a spot-on match for Adolf Hitler. In a huff, Hitler declares that he is Der Führer, puffing up his chest in indignation. Following this, he asks if the owner has Stürmer or Panzerber, to which the newsstand owner replies with a copy of the paper that Hitler has asked to see. There is clear amazement on Hitler's face as he realizes how many Turkish citizens there are in Berlin. After reading through the newspaper for a bit, Hitler realizes that his Third Reich did not win the war and that his beloved country has lost much of the prestige he fought to preserve. Eventually, he deems the entire war effort to be one giant waste. Fabian is sobbing as he looks at samples of his video reporting, lamenting the loss of his job. His mother attempts to calm him and suddenly tells him to pause the video he's looking at. She has noticed Hitler in the background. Fabian, upon seeing this, is intrigued by the image of Der Führer. The newsstand owner, finally tired of Hitler, tells him to keep the paper, but stand off to the side. He then suggests that Hitler clean himself up, starting with his clothing. Eventually, Hitler makes his way to a laundromat and asks random people if they will clean his uniform. He also states that he will need another uniform, as he cannot walk around naked. After someone is kind enough to help him, Hitler returns to the newsstand wearing a pair of blue jeans and a tan sweater. Fabian, who has been trying to retrace Hitler's steps, has arrived at the newsstand and is there when Hitler arrives. Getting a good look at Hitler, he is amazed by what he sees. Taking a chance, Fabian asks Hitler if he can film him as he makes his way through modern Germany. Intrigued, Hitler agrees. The two find their way to a hotel where Hitler is amazed by the modern wonders that are to be seen, particularly the televisions that are so plentiful. At Hitler's insistence, he and Fabian begin to talk about politics and how things have changed over the years. Hitler discovers that democracy had a minimal impact on the country after his time. After wandering the city for a while, and gathering information from random people, Hitler and Fabian return to the hotel. Hitler is given much to think about after hearing the consensus of how his ideas were considered to be harmful rather than helpful to the country during his time. It is without any doubt a shock to dare further to learn that Germany was reviled for many years following the war. A while later, the two men end up on a farm where Hitler is bitten by a dog. His reaction, to take out his gun and shoot at the animal, angers Fabian, who yanks the gun from Hitler's hands. As things continue along, Fabian begins to run short on funds but comes up with another plan that helps to put more money into his pocket. Convincing passers-by to sit and have their sketch drawn by Hitler. Despite the sarcastic images that are produced by the former leader, several people are pleased and gladly pay the fee that Fabian charges. After collecting enough money to continue their journey, Fabian and Hitler return to town, where Fabian shows his footage to Christoph. Impressed by the number of views that Fabian's video has collected on the internet, Christoph attempts to gain Hitler's real name and contact number. After meeting the man, however, Christoph's impression changes as he believes the man to be crazed. Telling Fabian to take his unstable actor and go, the two then enter Bellini's office, where Hitler then asks Bellini to help him save Germany from what it's become. Bellini is intrigued. Bellini then tasks her assistant with preparing a TV format for broadcasting Hitler's idea. It is then that Fabian gives Christoph an ultimatum, give him the job back or lose a chance at this great idea. Christoph offers Fabian a lesser role, with the opportunity to move up when a new post opens up. Later on, Hitler is given his time in the TV studio. Christoph has someone help Hitler with his computer skills, and dare fewer marvels at the invention, recalling how simple the computers of his day were in comparison. Setting Hitler up with an email and an online presence proves to be a bit troubling since others have adopted his name as their online identity, but eventually, Hitler is given the tag New Reichskanzlerin, which he enjoys. Christoph has a plan to include Hitler in a comedy show, as he is a bit salty that Bellini was given a promotion and a hot story to work with. His plan is simple, to cause as much trouble as possible for Bellini by asking questions about racism and other matters that could trip Hitler up. Once the show starts, reactions are as many would expect, as Hitler's appearance and his ideas of how the world is currently a mess and that its many inventions, including TV, are great, but things are not as they should be. Once Hitler starts on about change and reform, people embrace his ideas, thereby defeating Christoph's plans to discredit Bellini. Following the first broadcast, Hitler's popularity soars upward as people seek to embrace his ideas for change, which astounds Christoph. It's not too long, however, before a photo of Hitler shooting the dog at the farm during his trip with Fabian surfaces, and Adolf doubles down on the idea that he would shoot the dog again. Hitler's ensuing tirade after this lands Bellini in hot water puts Christoph in a good mood as the people turn on Hitler, and sees Adolf finally moving in with Fabian, where he begins to write a second book. Once the book hits the market, the studio and Christoph take note yet again and decide to bring Hitler and Fabian back. The idea gains ground as Bellini, now working in her own studio, is seen standing over Hitler, who has landed in the hospital after being accosted by several thugs that gave him a sound beating. Fabian then arrives, trying to convince Bellini that this is the actual Adolf Hitler, which she does not believe. Claiming that Hitler is seeking to fool people with his propaganda once again, Fabian eventually drags Hitler to the top of the hospital, pulling a gun on him, and accusing Hitler of his crimes and his intentional wrongdoing. Hitler laughs at and mocks Fabian, claiming the people back in the 1930s elected a strong leader who would guide their country into the future. Fabian then shoots Hitler, knocking him off the building. The voice of Hitler is then heard and seen in the background, telling Fabian that no German will ever forget his voice. At that moment Bellini yells cut, revealing that the scene was being filmed the entire time in a sound studio. The cast and crew cheer for the powerful scene, and it is revealed that an actor was standing in for the part of Fabian. Later, it can be seen that Fabian is currently in a mental institution, while Hitler and Bellini are busy giving autographs outside the sound studio. Those gathered near the pair appear to adore Hitler, as many are smiling approvingly. Subscribe for more videos like this.